How everybody doing today? So when was the last time you were encouraged to invest in your own imagination? Oh, that's good. Albert Einstein once said, the key or one of the true signs of intelligence isn't knowledge, but imagination. Therefore, creativity is just intelligence having a little fun. So let's have a little fun. Okay, see, this is my first time speaking on a platform like this at a event of this nature. Don't get me wrong, I'm an artist, so I've done countless open mics, talent shows. I even once opened up for the rapper 50 Cent. So being on stage isn't new to me, as well as people telling me I should be a speaker. I just never really put thought into speaking to audiences until about a couple months ago. So I just started putting a little more thought and, you know, energy into what it would be like to speak at events like this. I didn't do too much. I watched a few YouTube videos, read some material on public speaking, and just put more thought into it. So fast forward a month, I get an email from a friend that I met a while ago. And every time we would meet up, we would speak about just all sorts of things and have all sorts of stimulating conversations. So she also would tell me I should look into speaking a few. So I get an email and it pretty much says she was one of the creative coordinators at a TEDx event and I should look into coming to speaking. So that's why I think it's ironic that I'm here today to talk to you about bridging the gap between your imagination and your manifestations. How to be the dreamer and the doer. How to be the visionary that holds his vision with such focus, desire, belief, and expectancy that it manifests for the whole world to see. See, to sum it up in one sentence, our mind is a magnet. It's no way around it. It's what the ancient philosophers call the law of attraction. See, the universal laws applies to everyone, no matter your race, color, creed, or background. Once you accept this truth, it makes life much better off, much better off. You must learn to be master of your thoughts, master of your mind, and creator of the desires you wish to have. You could create great health, joy, love, abundance, anything you desire. You must tell yourself, I am great love, I am great health, I am wealth. See, these ideals will impress on your subconscious mind. See, your subconscious mind is that quiet little listener that's listening to everything you say, think, or feel. See, a lot of people don't realize why certain things happen to them or happen for them. Like, I had a friend of mine that got really sick last month. Oops, sorry about the word that. And the first thing he said to me was, I wasn't thinking about sickness. How did I attract that to me? Well, I told him, in the world we live in today, you don't have to think about sickness, negativity, war, or poverty, because the world is always thinking that for you. See, we have to be cautious when we let into our minds. See, you could be watching your favorite TV show, and like three different commercials about three different illnesses come on, and start impressing these symptoms on your subconscious mind. And before you know it, you're feeling the same symptoms you heard 100 times and don't even know why. To the professor's point, it's because everything around us is energy. Before they discovered light waves, they had no clue how light traveled from one place to another. They could measure the strength of brightness, but they didn't know how it traveled. Then they discovered it was light waves. Well, sometimes light waves, sometimes it's particles. One of the most famous equations is Einstein's E equals MC squared, which pretty much states that matter and energy are the same thing. So if you multiply matter by the speed of light, then you get pure energy. So everything in this world, or in this universe, is made up of the same stuff. We're all just a blob of atoms. So at the most minute level, a physicist studying atoms It's pretty much atoms just trying to figure themselves out. Everything around us is energy. Nikola Tesla once said, my brain is just a receiver. From the universe, there's a core that we obtain strength, knowledge, and inspiration. I have yet to penetrate these secrets, but I know it exists. If you want to understand the secrets of the universe, you must think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. See, we think reality is what we experience through the limited ability of our senses. See, our eyes see between infrared and ultraviolet light, though it's light bouncing all around us. Our ears can hear the very limited range that you can't even hear a dog whistle. So that makes it highly likely that there are tons of energy, vibrations, and frequencies around us that we're just not aware of. If it's just because we don't have the right tools that receive it, or just not taking the proper action to access it. Don't get me wrong. You gotta put your mind and change your thought patterns and accept that the fact that energy is all around us. When you make this shift, it will make life better off. See, what makes us special as humans is our consciousness. And with our consciousness, it makes us co-creators with the universe. See, if you match the frequency of the reality you want, then that's the reality you get. It could be no other way. This is not just a philosophy, this is physics. So we have to really start paying attention to what we think and kind of start to change our thought patterns, if necessary. We got to look into our mind and figure out what do we need today to prepare us forward into the future. Not yesterday, but today. See, today we are faced with an obstacle called conditioning. We are all victims of it. We are all conditioned by someone else's philosophy, whether it's religion, politics, what diet we should follow, what's right, what's wrong, and so on and so on. Don't get me wrong, I have read everything from Ernest Holmes to James Allen, Abraham Hicks, to Bob Proctor, even Watching the Secret. And whether you agree with these philosophies or not, the one thing that you can't deny is that everything around us is energy. So therefore, we have to ask ourselves, what type of energy am I putting out? What am I thinking about all the time? What's my current state? Do I have a desired new reality? And if so, what is it? How detailed is it? Do I have an emotional attachment with it? Does it move? See, when I fantasized about being up here, I didn't just see me up here. I seen it from this perspective, looking at y'all now. So you have to immerse yourself in a vision. You have to really believe and know it will happen. And you can't let negativity derail you from the things you want to create. And you most definitely can't let the non-believers affect your thoughts. See, some people are so negative that if they stepped into a dark room, they would start to develop. You know, like photographs. Pay them no mind. Because see, some people just know too much. They know so much, they could tell you every reason why something don't work. So you have to have your thoughts stronger than the non-belief, than the doubt. And you have to know no matter your current situation, you can manifest your desires. We are all co-creators with the universe. That is just a fact. And you have to know this. You are here to become the greatest version of yourself. No matter what. I'm sorry, y'all. Changing our thinking but can not seem natural when you've been thinking the same way your entire life. Like, for instance, give you an example. When I was in high school, I took a bowling class. So I bowled a lot. And every time I would throw the ball, it would curve all the way to the left. So what I started to do was move all the way to the right, aim at the furthest pin to the right, and throw it knowing it would curve to the left. To the class, I looked like all pro. But to me and the teacher, it was obvious something was wrong. My grip and release was wrong. And if I worked on that and fixed the problem, it would have been fixed. But I never fixed the problem because I wasn't motivated to be a great bowler. So if I would have put in the work to fix it, that unnatural feeling would eventually feel natural. And I know this because on the flip side, I also played basketball. But I had the worst shooting form ever. But I really loved basketball. And I was going to high school the next year, and I really, really wanted to make the team. So I practiced, practiced, and practiced. I shot like 1,000 jumpers every day that summer. And I would visualize so many game time scenarios. I mean, I hit more game time jumpers in my mind that summer than Kobe Bryant did his whole career. We end up happening, end up making a team, starting as a sophomore, and was co-captain by my junior year. How did this happen? I didn't realize what I was doing at the time, but in hindsight, I was applying visualization, desire, belief, and I was adding the inspired action to move it forward. Not just the going through the motion actions like I did with bowling, but I was adding inspired, motivating action. So it's kind of like what you're thinking is the same thing. See, we used to doing something one way and we get okay results. So we just compensate. But if you work on changing your thinking completely, you'll get the same type of results like I did with basketball. So, what's the way we could change our thinking? Something that worked for me, I would write a journal about situations where I didn't act or behave the way I wanted to. Now I would rewrite the situation as if I did act or behave the way I wanted to. What this would do, it would make your mind start thinking in more resourceful ways. I guarantee if you do it, it will start impressing new ideas on your subconscious mind. It will show your subconscious that you're serious about your goals, your dreams, and your desires. And once your subconscious and the universe realize you're serious, your mind will shift. You'll start to see opportunities you never thought existed. You'll start to think in new ways you never thought. New ideas about making money, starting a relationship, getting in shape, will just pop in your mind. Like I said, you have to realize you are here to become the greatest version of yourself. As a co-creator, it is your job to think of a better creation of everything you have created thus far, especially if you want life to happen the way you want it to. See, the essence of your happiness is this. If life is going the way you want it to, then you happy. If life not going the way you want it to, then you're not happy. So if you want life to go the way you want it to, it's all about how you think, what you think, with how much focus and desire you think about it. Do you truly believe it can happen? And the stability of your thought process. See, a lot of times we let the negative thoughts tell us what's possible and what's not possible. That is not your concern. All you have to do is strive for what you want. See, y'all sitting here now, and if I ask you, can he fly away from where he is? Y'all would say no. If I ask you, can she walk away from where she is? You would say yes. So you have to realize the basis of this is on your past life experience. See, you have walked away plenty of times, so you know it's possible. And it's safe to say none of us has flown away yet. See, the basis of this, you're pretty much determining what hasn't happened up until this point can't happen. You're truly underestimating the power of the human spirit. What hasn't happened up until this point can happen. So what's possible and not possible is not your concern. Let the universe decide that. If you're creating your thoughts in a powerful way and not letting doubt and negativity take away the intensity of it, and you're adding inspired action with it, you will most definitely create or bridge the gap between imagination and manifestation. I'm gonna wrap this up real quick, but I want to leave y'all with this one saying. Your mind is a garden, your thoughts are the seeds. You could grow flowers, or you could grow weeds. So make sure you plant seeds of greatness. Thank you.